decision. We call the council. We're all taking the right decision. When it comes to Gaza, it's ongoing war. We need a ceasefire. We need divestment.
Yeah, Rick!
Yeah, Rick!
says he wants to leave. If you do not disperse, you may be arrested and or subject to other police action. Other police action may include actual physical removal, the use of riot control agents, and or less lethal munitions, which could cause risk or injury to those that remain.
Thank you. testing, testing. Hey, all protesters, our representative would like to speak to you. Stand by. Anyone that refuses to leave will be arrested.
Thank you. So a group of about 150 of us were here from Jewish Voice for Peace, CARE Philadelphia, Philly Palestine Coalition, Harrisburg Coalition, Pennsylvania Taxpayers, saying that it is a disgrace that Pennsylvania, specifically our Pennsylvania Treasurer Stacey Garrity, has $56 million to send to Israel, yet SEPTA is failing, yet our roads are failing, yet our schools are filled with asbestos, yet our minimum wage is still $7.25 in this state, yet we have $56 million to send to a foreign country that's committing a genocide against the people of Gaza. Yeah, so the coalition has been active, a coalition of these organizations has been active for about 4 months since the genocide started. We have staged sit-ins, we've staged protests, we've staged large marches of upwards of 10,000 people to say that we will not stand by idly while there's a genocide happening, and we've been at it for about 4 months and we do not plan on stopping. So the core of this is that, again, we think it is an absolute disgrace that we can find $56 million to send to a foreign country. We are really demanding that that money be, those bonds be sold, and that that money be reinvested into our communities, reinvested locally into housing, into jobs, into schools, into a green economy, right? And that we as a state should not be funding the genocide of Palestinians. 30,000 people have died in Gaza, and we are complicit in it. So I think we're here specifically calling out Pennsylvania Treasurer Stacey Garrity, who is on a board at Israel Bonds, the organization. And she, the state of Pennsylvania had already invested $36 million into Israel Bonds. And on October 12th, 5 days after the genocide in Gaza started, she invested another $20 million into Israel Bonds. And she has unilateral power to do so. So the legislature does not have to approve. The governor does not have to approve. She invested that money into Israel Bonds. And so we are here saying that she is complicit, that the legislature is complicit by sitting by while their money goes to Israel instead of to their constituents, and that we are here to let the taxpayers know that this is happening. So personally, I live in Philadelphia. I live next to a school, an public elementary school that did not have a working bathroom for their kindergartners for years, right? So what I would want that money to go to is I want that money to go to our schools to fix the asbestos and the lead in the water and the not working bathrooms and the crumbling hallways. That $56 million could go to remediate those schools. We're not stopping until the genocide is over. That's it.
That spurs us on into long-term campaign work to end the occupation of Palestine.
And I just, like, there was a moment that we both had where we looked around this room and we were like, oh my God, we're doing it, right? Like, we're building a powerful coalition of allies and Palestinians and Muslims and Arabs and anti-Zionist Jews that have taken action together, and I'm really excited for what this is going to produce for the future, right? No matter what this what happens after this moment, right, I am invested in building long-term power with you all until we see a free Palestine.
Real quick. First of all, everybody give yourself a round of applause. And as amazing as this action was, the reality is we have a lot more work to do. But right now, you're sitting in the masjid that I grew up in. And what this moment means to me is that anyone here from Allentown, from Lancaster, from Wilkes-Barre, from Scranton, from Philly, this is your home.
Yes.
This is your home when you're coming through Harrisburg, and these are the people that are ready to work with you in every movement we have to do in order to free Palestine. So, to my aunties and my brothers who set all of this up, to the people that I haven't even seen but just came out the jail cell for putting their bodies on the line, to the organizers, and to every single person that was a part of this, we got a family that we're building, and we're all here for each other. I love y'all, and thank you guys for coming out and giving yourself.